हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू हैव डिस्कशन अबाउट टुडेज आईआईटी पेपर. ओके, सो सी हियर, इन दैट फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन वाज एक्स स्क्वेयर माइनस टू एक्स प्लस वन इज अ पॉलिनोमियल ऑफ वन वेरिएबल. दिस आंसर इज वेरी सिंपल, वन वेरिएबल, बिकॉज ओनली वन वेरिएबल इज यूज. ओके, सो वेरी सिंपल आंसर. सो ए इज द करेक्ट ऑप्शन. सेकेंड थिंग, अ बायनोमियल ऑफ डिग्री 20 इन द फॉलोइंग इज डिग्री 20. डिग्री मीन्स दिस इज एक्स बाय 20, दिस इज 20x, दिस इज कोएफिशिएंट, दिस इज डिवाइडेड बाय 20 एंड हियर दिस इज एक्स रेस टू 20. सो दिस पॉलिनोमियल हैव डिग्री 20. ओके, सो सी इज द करेक्ट ऑप्शन. अंडरस्टूड. सो नाउ क्वेश्चन नंबर 3. आफ्टर दिस क्वेश्चन नंबर 3 इज द वैल्यू ऑफ f of x 5x minus 4x square plus 3 when x is equal to minus 1. Okay, x is equal to minus 1 means here we have to put in the here 5 into minus 1. F of minus 1 we are finding here, minus 4 into minus 1 square. So 5 into minus 1 minus 5, 4 into minus 1 square will be 1. So minus 5 minus 4. Okay, minus 5 into minus 4, that is plus 3, minus 5, here again 3 is there. Okay, minus 5 minus 4 minus 9 plus 3, that will be minus 6. So here minus 6 is the correct answer. Okay, after that question number 4 is the value of pt plus 2 plus t plus 2 t square minus t cube is equal when t is equal to 0. So just at the place of t we need to put 0. So t 2 plus 0 plus 2 into 0 square minus 0 cube. So it will be the whole, this is going to remain 0 only. So answer is 2. So A is the correct option. Okay. So after that, question number 5. Question number 5 is A upon B is equal to A upon B plus B upon A minus 1. Okay, and here a b is not equal to 0 and we have to find out value of this. Okay, so first we will use this a upon b plus b upon a is equal to minus 1. So cross multiplication a square plus b square upon a b is equal to minus 1. So a square plus b square is equal to a b into minus 1 minus a b. Okay, so this we can use a square plus b square plus a b is equal to 0 minus a b, you will take that this side. Now a cube minus b cube, we know the identity. What is the expansion of this? A minus b, a square plus b square plus a b, a square plus b square plus a b, that is a minus b we will keep as it is. The value of this is 0. Okay, a square plus b square, a square plus b square plus a b, this is 0. So multiply by 0, so a minus b into 0 is 0. Okay, so which option is correct? Option C is the correct answer. Okay, next see question number 6. First we will solve this directly here. 81 y square minus k is equal to, this is a plus b a minus b, so we can write this 9y square minus 1 by 2 square. So you will get here 9y square is 81 y square minus 1 by 4. Here also 81 y square minus k, so this both will be cancelled, minus k is equal to minus 1 by 4. So k is equal to 1 by 4. So 1 by 4 means option B is the correct answer. Okay. So now after this question number 7. Question number 7 see, if x plus 1 is a factor of the polynomial 2x square plus kx, then the value of k, x plus 1 is factor, means we need to put x is equal to minus 1 in the polynomial, that is 2 into minus 1 square plus k into minus 1. Okay, so 2 into minus 1 square will be plus 1, multiply by 1, k into minus 1 will be minus k. So 2 ones are 2, 2 minus k is equal to 0. So 2 is equal to plus k. So k, value of k is 2. So that is C is the correct answer. Then question number 8. Here it is very simple, a plus b a minus b, 99 plus 98 and 99 minus 98, a plus b a minus b. So it will be this sum is 197 and this difference is 1. So answer is 197. So B is the correct answer. Okay. Then after this, question number 9. Here question number 9 is 1 plus 7x square plus 49x square minus 1 is. Okay. So see here, we can take this 1 plus 7x bracket square plus 49x square, we can write 7x bracket square minus 1 square. Okay. A square minus b square property we can use. So we need to bring in that form. So 1 plus 7x bracket square plus here we can write 7x plus 1 and 7x minus 1. Okay. So now here we can take 1 plus 7x common from both the terms. So 1 plus 7x we have taken common. What is going to remain in bracket? 1 plus 7x, from this 1 plus 7x is remaining, and here plus 7x minus 1. Okay. So finally you will get 1 plus 7x, and here if you solve, minus 1 plus 1 will be cancelled, and what is going to remain? 14x. So 14x is a factor and 1 plus 7x, but 1 plus 7x is not given in the option. So 14x is given, so option D is the correct answer. Okay. This is next also very simple. By splitting middle term we need to solve. So you can do this 6x square plus 9x plus 2x plus 3. So 3x you can take common. What is going to remain? 2x plus 3 plus 1, 2x plus 3. So 2x plus 3 and another bracket, 3x plus 1. Okay. So the factors are getting in the option A. Okay. So A is the correct answer. Now see next question number 11. Question number 11 is the difference between sides at right angles in a right angle triangle is 14 centimeter. The area of the triangle is 120 centimeter square. The perimeter of the triangle is, okay. So what is given? See, the difference between sides at right angle in a right angle triangle is 14 centimeter. Okay. So suppose one side we will consider, let one side be x. Okay. So what will be the length of other side? Other side will be x minus 14, because sum is given 14, the difference is given 14. Okay. Now if you are going to find out area of triangle, then you can use half into height into base, or base into height. Okay. So area of triangle is given 120 centimeters. So that we can put here, 120 is equal to half into the area of the triangle. One side height is x, and another is x minus 14. Okay. So now 120 multiplied by 2, 240 is equal to x into x square minus 14x. So you will get again here one quadratic equation, x square minus 14x minus 240 is equal to 0. So now we can factorize this by splitting middle term, that is x square minus 24x plus 10x, 24 into 10, 240 you will get, minus 240. Okay. So x minus 24, x plus 10 is equal to 0. Okay. x minus 24 plus, you can take here, plus 10, x minus 24, here 24 will come, minus 24. So you will get two factors, x minus 24 and another x plus 10 is equal to 0. X minus 24 is equal to 0, so x is equal to 24. This you will get negative, x is equal to minus 10, so it is rejected. So we will consider x is equal to 24. If x is equal to 24, x minus 24 will be 24 minus x is equal to 24, so x minus 14 we have taken, so x is 24 minus 14 will be 10. Okay. So now hypotenuse we will consider A. Okay. So A square is equal to sum of the other two sides. So one side is 24, one side is 10. So 24 square plus 10 square, 24 square is 576 plus 10 square is 100, that is 676. So it will be 26. 676 is the square of 26. So A is 26. Okay. Now they are asking perimeter. Okay. The perimeter of the triangle. So sides are 26, 10 and 24. 26 plus 10 plus 24 is equal to 60. Okay. So 60 is the correct answer. Okay. Now Next question, see, one diagonal and side of the rhombus are 24 centimeter and 13 centimeter respectively. Find the area of the other diagonal and find the area and other diagonal. Okay, we have to find out. You know that rhombus, diagonals of rhombus are bisecting and perpendicular bisectors. Okay, what is given? One diagonal and side diagonal is given 24, so this is 12 and this is 12. Okay, and side is given 13, and this is perpendicular bisector. So suppose I am saying this is A, B, C, D, and this is, I will say, O. So here AO square plus OD square is equal to AD square. AO square don't know, so we will keep as it is. OD is 12 square is equal to 13 square. So AO square is equal to 13 square is 169 minus 12 square is 144. So 169 minus 144 is 25. So AO is equal to 5. AO is equal to 5. Understood. Now find the area they are asking. AO is equal to 5. So what is the length of the other diagonal? AC is equal to 5 multiplied by 2. 5 multiplied by 2, that is 10 centimeter. Okay. But 10 centimeters are getting in two options, this here and here. So we need to find out area. Suppose I want to find out area of this triangle, how I can find out? Half into base into height. So half multiplied by base is 12 and height is 5. So 2 6 are 12, 6 5 are 30 centimeter square. Okay. So 30 is the area of one triangle. Like that, how many triangles are there? 4 triangles. So 30 multiplied by 4. So 3 4 are 120 centimeter square. So 120 and 10. These are getting in option C. So C is the correct answer. Okay. So after this question number 13. Question number 13 is ABCD is a trapezium with AB is equal to AB 10 centimeter, AD is equal to 5 centimeter, BC is equal to 4 centimeter and DC is equal to 7 centimeter. Okay. This example we can do directly with the help of formula, that is area of trapezium is equal to half into sum of parallel sides into height. So you can do directly half into sum of parallel. Here parallel sides are 10 and 7. So sum of parallel side 10 plus 7 multiply by height. Height means it should be 90 degree. It should be perpendicular to the base. So that height we will consider 4. So 2 to the 4, what is going to remain here? 10 plus 7, 17 to the 34 centimeter square. So here option A is the correct answer. Okay. Question number 16 is C. That is also very simple. Find the area and perimeter of right angle triangle whose hypotenuse is 5 centimeter. Hypotenuse is 5 centimeter and base is 4 centimeter. Okay. With the help of hypotenuse and base, we can find out another side, or 5, 4 and 3 is the Pythagorean triplet. So directly, not necessary to do any calculations, directly you can get 3, 4 and 5. This is a Pythagorean triplet. So definitely this length will be 3 centimeter. Now we have to find out area and perimeter. Perimeter, what is the perimeter? 5 plus 3, 8, 8 plus 4, 12. Perimeter will be 12 centimeter. Now area, how we can find out? Half into base into height. What is base? 4 and height is 3. So 2 2s are 4, 3 2s are 6 centimeter square. Okay. So 12 and 6. First find the area. Area they are asking. Area is 6 centimeter square, and this is the correct answer. Here also it is given 12 and 6, but here it is given in centimeter square. So this is not correct. So A is the correct answer. Okay. Now question number 15. Question number 15 is, in an isosceles triangle ABC with AB and AC 13 centimeter, D is the midpoint. Isosceles triangle ABC, suppose we will consider ABC, AB and AC are 13 centimeter. This and this is 30 isosceles triangle. D is the midpoint of BC. Also BC is equal to 10 centimeter. So this is 5 and this is 5. This is midpoint. So definitely it will divide 5 centimeter. Which of the following is true? Okay, area of the triangle ABD and ADC are equal. Definitely here base and height is equal for both, so this is correct answer. Area of triangle ABD, so we need to find out ABD, area of triangle ABD is equal to half into base into height. Base is 5 and height is AD, so we need to find out AD. How will find out AD? By Pythagoras, because this is height is perpendicular, okay, altitude is perpendicular to the base, so we can find out AD square is equal to AD square plus BD square is equal to AB square. AD square we are going to find out is equal to AB square. What is AB? 13 square. 13 square minus 5 square. BD will take directly. 13 square is 169 minus 25, that is 144. So AD is equal to 12 centimeter. AD is equal to 12 centimeter. Understood? Now area, suppose I want to find out, then how I will get area? Half into this formula, half into 5 into 12. So 2 6 are 12, 6 5 are 30, 30 centimeter square. Okay, this is 30 and this is also 30. So if you will observe here, third area of triangle ABC is going to get 30 plus 30, 60. So all the above options are correct. All options are correct. So D is the correct answer. Now question number 16. A triangle and a parallelogram have the same base and the same area. Triangle, a parallelogram and a triangle have the, so this is triangle, have the same base. Both are standing on the, this triangle and this parallelogram are on the same base. Okay. So definitely in this case, when triangle and parallelogram are two figures having same base and same heights, same base and the same area. Okay, so here it is given directly, say area is same. So area of triangle is equal to area of parallelogram. Okay, area of triangle, how we solve? Base into half into base into height. Okay, and area of triangle, area of triangle is equal to area of parallelogram is equal to base into height. Area of parallelogram is base into height. Area of triangle we have taken as it is. Base they have told us 28 centimeter. This is 28 centimeter. So we will keep here 28 centimeter into height. And area of triangle is unknown. Area of triangle is not given. But we can find out here because sides are given 26, 30 and 28. So this I am taking 26. This I am taking 30 and this is 28. So with the help of Heron's formula we can find out this. Okay, so what will be the semi-perimeter? Semi-perimeter is equal to 26 plus 30 plus 28 divided by 2. Okay, so it will be 84 divided by 2, that is 42 centimeter. Okay, so directly now I'm using here area of triangle is equal to S in S minus A into S minus B into S minus C. So semi perimeter is 42 minus 26, 42 minus 28 and 42 minus 30 is equal to 42 multiply by 42 minus 26 is equal to 16. 14 multiplied by 12. When you will solve this, that time you will get 336 centimeter square. Okay, so this is the area of triangle which we need to put here in this formula. Okay, so now I am putting that here because here we have taken area of triangle is equal to 28 centimeter into height. Okay, so we will put here area of triangle is equal to 336 centimeter square. This we are using. Okay, is equal to 28 centimeter multiplied by height. So height is equal to 336 divided by 28. So 12 centimeter. So A is the correct answer. Now question number 17. Question number 17 is the base of an isosceles right triangle. Isosceles right triangle means definitely these two sides are same. Okay, these two sides are equal, because this is the longest side. So base of an isosceles triangle is 30. If this is 30, this also 30 we can consider. So directly we can directly, not necessary to find out its area they are asking. So half into base into height, so half into base is 30, height is 30, okay. So 215, 15 threes are 45, 450 centimeter square, or else you can find out this, we can find out this by Pythagoras property, and then by Heron's formula we can find out area, okay. So 450 centimeter square is the correct answer, okay. Now question number 18. The sides of a triangle are 11 centimeter, 15 centimeter and 16 centimeter. So first what we will do, we are going to use here Heron's formula. So 11 plus 15 plus 16 is equal to 42 centimeter. So semi perimeter is equal to 21. So area is equal to, directly I am putting now value 21 minus 11, 21 minus 15 and 21 minus 16. So here 21 into 10 into 6 into 5, okay. So now here 7 into 3 into 5 2s are into 3 into 2 into 5, this we have factorized, okay. So if you will take those factors are in pair, that we can take outside, 5 multiply by 3 multiply by 2 and 7 is single, so 7 will remain out inside. 5 3 is a 15, 15 2 is a 30, 30 root 7, okay, that is the area. Now what they are asking, the altitude to the longest side is, altitude to the longest side, okay. So area of triangle we will use, area of triangle is equal to half into base into height. Area of triangle we have, that is 30 root 7 is equal to half into base. Longest side, which one is the longest side? 16 centimeter. So 16 we will take height, 2 8s are 16, 8 will come this side, 30 root 7 divided by 8, 30 root 7 divided by 8, so 2 4s are, and here 15. So height is equal to 15 root 7 divided by 4, 15 root 7 divided by 4, so C is the correct answer, okay. Now 19th one, see, the length of the sides of triangle ABC are consecutive integers. So we will consider x plus 1 and x plus 2, three sides are there and consecutive, okay. Triangle ABC has the same perimeter as an equilateral triangle with a side of length 9 centimeter, okay. Same perimeter as same as equilateral triangle, so definitely its perimeter will be 9 into 3, because that is equilateral triangle, 9 3s are 27 centimeter. So we will add them, x plus 1, x plus 2 is equal to 27. So you will get, this is x plus x, 3x plus 3 is equal to 27. So 3x is equal to 27 minus 3, 24. So x is equal to 3 8s are 24. They are asking what is the length of the shortest side. So x is the shortest side, so 8 centimeter is the correct answer. So C is correct answer. Now question number 20. The length of a median of an equilateral triangle is x centimeter. Then its area is equilateral triangle. The length of median, this is median. Okay, median is always perpendicular. So suppose this is ABC, this is D, and this length is x. Okay. So this much only given, and we have to choose the correct option from this. So what we will do? Let the side of equilateral triangle B S, okay, capital S. So what is the, this is S, so what is the length of BD? BD will be S by 2, because this is the midpoint, altitude and median is same for equilateral triangle, so S by 2, okay. Suppose now in triangle ABD I will use Pythagoras property, then what I will get, AB square is equal to BD square plus AD square. So AB is, what is AB? AB is S, we have considered, because equilateral triangle side we have considered S. So S square is equal to S by 2 square plus X square. This we can take here, S square minus S square upon 4. We can remove bracket, is equal to X square. Okay. So now what is going to remain? 4S square minus S square divided by 4 is equal to X square. So X square is equal to 4S minus S square, 3S square upon 4. So x square is equal to what? x is equal to what? X is equal to root 3 s upon 2. If you will remove, this is perpet square, this will go in under root and s. Okay. So, what is the value of s? S is equal to 2x divided by root 3. This is the side. Okay. Now, area of triangle they are asking. Find the area. Okay. So, area of triangle is equal to half into base into height. Okay. Half into base into height. So, now half into base into height. Okay. Root 3 by height is x. Height we have considered s. What is the base? Base will be 2x, 2s by root 3. 2s by root 3. Okay. So now 2s by root 3. Okay. So now here 2 will be cancelled. What is going to remain here? 2x by root 3. X square by root 3 centimeter square. X square by root 3 centimeter square. Okay. So option C is the correct answer. Okay. Now next see question number 21. 2x plus 3y is equal to 8. XY is equal to minus 1. Find 4x square plus 9y square. So we will use this 2x plus 3y is equal to 8. We will take square of both the sides. So what you will get here? 2x square is 4x square plus 3y square 9y square. Product of these two, it will be plus 12xy is equal to 64. Okay, they are asking this 4x square plus 9y square is equal to plus 12 into xy value is given minus 1 is equal to 64. So 4x square plus 9y square minus 12 is equal to 64. So 4x square plus 9y square is equal to 64 plus 12, that is 64 plus 12 is 76. So 76 is the correct answer. Okay. If x plus 2 is a factor of x square plus 5x plus a, then the value of a is x plus 2 means x is equal to minus 2, we will put here. So minus 2 square plus 5 into minus 2 plus a is equal to 0. When you will put this is factor, remainder is going to be 0. So minus 2 square will be 4 minus 10 plus a is equal to 0. So it will be minus 4 minus this will be minus 6 plus a is equal to 0. So a is equal to plus 6. So 6 is the correct answer here. Okay. Next question is find the zero of the polynomial 3x minus 21. So 3x minus 21 means 3x is equal to 21. X is equal to 3 sevens are 21. 7 is the correct answer. Now question number 24. If the area of an equilateral triangle is 16 root 3 centimeter square, find the perimeter of the triangle. So we know the formula of area of equilateral triangle, root 3 by 4 into side square. Okay. And that is given 16 root 3. Okay. So s square is equal to what? 16 root 3 multiplied by 4 upon root 3. Root 3 will be cancelled. 16 4s are 64. 64. So s is equal to 8. And they are asking perimeter. So perimeter means this is equilateral triangle. So perimeter is equal to 8 multiplied by 3. 24 centimeter. 24. Okay. Only you have to write integers. So now next question is very simple. The semi perimeter of triangle having the length of its side 20. 15 and 9, 20 plus 15 plus 9 is equal to 44. 44 and semi perimeter means divided by 2, that is 22 centimeter. Okay. So this was the today's paper. It was very simple. Okay. Thank you.